With the release of Sword and Shield, we have gotten our first taste of Galar Form Pokemon in Pokemon Go with Galar Weezing. Now that the lid is off on Galar, more Galar Forms may be coming to Pokemon Go in the near future. This obviously has people asking, what are these Galar Forms and just how good are they in the meta? Well, in this video, I'm going over just that. Before I begin, I'd like to give a special shout out to Doom Nova on the Silph Road. Did an excellent breakdown of the stats and listing out what movesets that these Pokemon can learn, saving me a lot of time doing the math myself and rifling around the internet to figure out their move pools. I definitely suggest giving this Reddit post a check, link in the description to that. So first on the list, obviously, is the Galar Weezing. So Galar Weezing's stats make it so it's not viable in the PvE content. In fact, expect all of these Pokemon to not really be viable in PvE slash raid gym content, whatever you want to call it, unless stated otherwise. So we have to turn our sights to the PvP side of the force. As far as Galar Weezing goes in PvP, right now its only fast move is Tackle. So unless Pokemon Go makes a new fast move for Galar Weezing, which isn't too out of the question, we could use some new Fairy-type fast moves, just saying, it's probably not going to be too hot in PvP for a long while. On top of that, it's got relatively poor bulk, just like the Cantonian Weezing, and because of the Poison Fairy dual type, it has a weakness to Ground, Psychic, and Steel-type Pokemon attacks, which are pretty big in PvP, especially the Great League. If it does get a new fast move, it could pull ahead in Silph Cups as a fairy type that isn't weak to charm or a fairy type that isn't weak to poison. So that could be pretty interesting. But right now, Weezing, not so hot. Maybe just catch him, do some trades, maybe try to get the high rank, but nothing to invest in right now. Next up on our list is Linoon. Yeah, the reason why Linoon's next on our list is because it's, you know, in the Game Master already, so probably next on Pokemon Go's list, right? So this thing is basically Linoon, but with an added Dark typing, so it's kind of like Alolan Raticate 2.0. The current Game Master data suggests that it's going to have the same exact move pool as Linoon. This is subject to change before it's released, but for now, let's just assume that it's a Linoon with a Dark typing. As it stands right now, Linoon's a pretty good Pokemon in Great League PvP. It's sort of like this awkward Swiss Army knife. The question is, will the added Dark typing help it or hurt it? With the Dark type, it gains resistance to Psychic, Dark, and Ghost, which is pretty cool. But it comes at a cost, and that cost is being double weak to Fighting type attacks, which are rampant in PvP. And then you also gain a weakness to Charm and a weakness to Bug. Bug doesn't come up too much, but Charm is always out there, so kinda risky. I'd say right now the jury is a little bit out on just how good the new Linoon will be. I feel like the Dark type is gonna hold it back in the greater Great League, but when it comes to Cups, it does give another route for Linoon in general to come in, which could be pretty interesting. Because Hoenn Linoon is already really good, and this Galar Linoon has the same stats and arguably the same move pool, you'll definitely want to keep your eye out for a good ranked one. Next up, we have the Galar Rapidash. Galar Rapidash is a Psychic Fairy type Pokemon, so think about Gardevoir and Mr. Mime. And because I'm bad with Great League stat translations, I decided to compare regular Rapidash, which has the same stats as the Galar form, to Mr. Mime and Gardevoir, and you can see here that they're base stats are relatively similar, and their stat products are relatively similar. You can check out Gardevoir and see that, once again, relatively similar stat spreads. This means for Galar Rapidash to stand out, it's going to have to diverge from these two Pokemon. So if it were to get Charm or Confusion, that would be cool for it, but I feel like it definitely needs Psycho Cut in order to stand out. Those guys already do the Confusion Charm stuff. We need a faster Psychic Fairy to have some variety in the pool. On top of that, Rapidash could get Stomp or Body Slam for an earlier charge move to get that bait in, and then it also has Wild Charge and Drill Run for some alternative coverage. Now, when it comes to using these moves with Charm or Confusion, I just want to reiterate, those attacks are very slow to the charge moves, and I don't think that the alternative coverage or the alternative baits will really allow Galar Rapidash to stand out. I feel like the Psycho Cut is going to be what's really necessary for it to compete with Gardevoir and Mr. Mimewell. Next on our list is the Galar Farfetch'd, and I freaking love how this thing looks. It's got this giant leak, and it just looks like it's ready to fight everything. In fact, it's so ready to fight everything that it's actually a pure fighting type Pokemon. Now, as a pure fighting type Pokemon, for it to stand out in the Great League, it basically needs to have counter. It can learn counter in its moveset. We don't have game master information, but it's going to be a make or break thing for the Galar Farfetch'd if it gets counter or not. Now, counter is just the first step for Galar Farfetch'd to stand out. It also needs to get Sky Attack. With the combination of counter and Sky Attack, it's actually able to outrace Medicham, who is trying to build up to Psychic. With Leaf Blade as a better baiting move than Power Up Punch, a counter Leaf Blade Sky Attack Galar Farfetch'd could be a really good addition to fighting type cups or to cliffhanger type formats. As far as the Greater Great League goes, we've got Deoxys Defense Form roaming around, so it's kind of hard to be a counter user and compete with that guy in the Open Great League. But in more restricted formats, I could see Galar Farfetch'd being awesome. That reminds me, we are now into the Galar forms of already regional Pokemon. I don't know how Pokemon Go is going to tackle this situation. Maybe they're going to be egg-exclusive Pokemon. Maybe they're going to be alternative regional Pokemon. I'm honestly not sure. I don't have the answers here, so we're just going to have to wait and see what happens. Now we're on to Galar Corsola. Galar Corsola is a mono ghost type Pokemon, and once again, I'm not too good at the Great League stat translations, but from what I can tell, it seems to be a bulkier ghost type Pokemon than Drifblim or Dusclops, for instance. Now, in its move pool, it can learn Hex and Shadow Ball, and Hex plus Shadow Ball would be a pretty cool learn set for it. It would function sort of like a Dusclops that actually has Shadow Ball, or maybe a Drifblim that isn't sub-flying type. Furthermore, it could have Surf or Rock Slide as the secondary charge move, which would be pretty awesome for a bait and for the alternative coverage. So I have some pretty high expectations for the Galar of Corsola here. However, if it doesn't get Shadow Ball, then I think it's going to kind of be a little bit of a bust. Then to close off the regional variations, we have Mr. Mime. Why does this thing exist? Who green-lighted this thing? I don't know. At any rate, Galar Mr. Mime. So normal Mr. Mime is Psychic Fairy. This Mr. Mime is Psychic Ice. If you're not aware, Ice type is a very pitiful defensive type in Pokemon Go, and that's why you don't see many Ice type Pokemon topping the charts in PvP outside of like a cup scenario. Ice type just invites way too many weaknesses. As a result, a Pokemon that's not all that different from OG Mr. Mime, but without the fairy subtyping, I honestly don't see Ice type Galar Mr. Mime doing much of anything in PvP. Dark, Ghost, Steel, Rock, Fire, Bug. It's awful. Now we're on to Gen 5 Galar Pokemon, where the Gen 5 forms aren't already in the game yet, so how is Niantic going to do this? I don't know. First on our list here is Stunfisk. Now Stunfisk, the, you know, what the frick is this, Unova region? Yo, babe! Is Gen 5 Unova? Thank you. So the Unova Stunfisk is already pretty freaking sweet. I mean, it's ground and electric, and it has the best spammy type of attacks to combo with that, according to the current Game Master, when it finally comes out in Pokemon Go. As far as the Galar form goes, it's trading the electric subtyping for a steel subtyping. As far as Galar Stunfisk goes, I feel like the steel subtyping might kinda hurt it in the Open Great League, but when it comes to cups in particular, being a steel type that could potentially spam ground type attacks could be massive for the Galar Stunfisk. So keep your eyes peeled for that Pokemon when it comes out. And the Unova form too. Really good PvP looking Pokemon right here. Then finally, we have the man, the myth, the legend, the Darmanitan. Now Darmanitan, the Unova form, was already proffered to be one of the greatest Fire-type Pokemon in PvE content, so raid content. This is it. For you guys that don't care about PvP, this is the Pokemon, right? Well, Darmanitan, really cool, right? Cool thing about Darmanitan too is that it has a Zen form. The Zen form converts the offensive stats into defensive ones, and it gains a psychic subtyping. So the question is, when the Unova Darmanitan comes to Pokemon Go, how are they going to handle it? I feel like the Zen form is probably going to be like a raid exclusive Pokemon. They're not going to mess around with HP thresholds for it to transform like in the main series games. So that aside, the Unova form, Zen form, looks pretty hot for PvP because big defensive type, right? Well, when it comes to the Galar form, they kind of went in a different direction here. Yeah, so the base form of Darmanitan looks to be like a very good Ice-type Pokemon, on par with, if not slightly better than Mamoswine. However, the Zen form is like anything but Zen. It turns into a flaming, crazy snowman. I'm not making this up. This is real. Check Cerebee or something if you want to validate this thing. And instead of getting defensive stats, it just goes high up in the offensive. As a result, this fire ice Pokemon, if it gets the right moveset, will be the number one fire and ice type Pokemon in Pokemon Go, which is insane. If it gets the best moves, it could very easily be the top DPS Pokemon in the game, beating out Deoxys offense form, which is nuts. As you can see here on this chart, even if it doesn't get overheat as a fire type attacker, if it got fire blast or flamethrower even, it would be number one fire by a lot. Checking out this ice type graph here, you can see that even if it doesn't get avalanche, it gets blizzard or ice beam, it is still the best ice type Pokemon by a lot. So I don't know when we're going to get this Pokemon. Are we going to see it in 2019? Are we going to see it in 2020? Who knows? But unless Niantic just kind of poops all over this thing's move pool, this Pokemon seems like it's going to be the most iciest, hottest thing to ever come to Pokemon Go. Power creep, the power be creeping. Now, as far as the Galar forms of Meowth and Yamask go, yeah, definitely not doing anything crazy in Pokemon Go. And then as far as their evolutions are concerned, well, the evolutions aren't Galar forms of Pokemon we already have. It's not a Galar Confagurus, it's like Rungurus, and then instead of Persian, it's Perzerker. Because of that, I feel like they're going to be like Galar Stone evolutions in like 2022, 2023, when we finally get Gen 8. I feel like it's very unlikely that we're going to see them. We'll see their preforms, perhaps, but I don't think we're going to see the evolutions. As far as the future G-Stone evolutions go, the only one that really stands out to me is the Rungrius in PvP. I mean, Confagurus already has the base stats and potential move pool to be a really good Great League Pokemon, and Rungrius is basically a clone of that Pokemon with a ground subtyping. So if Rungrius somehow wins the moveset lottery in 2022, 2023, well then obviously it could be a really cool Great League Pokemon. But I honestly don't know what the meta is going to look like then, and nobody else does either, so we'll have to wait and see. And there you have it, the Galar form Pokemon. They're coming to Pokemon Go. When are they going to be released? How are they going to be released? I honestly am not sure, but this is basically how they're going to look. We don't have Game Master information on all of them, and the Game Master information we currently have on Zigzagoon and Linoon may change, but this is what you can expect from them at peak performance. Or in the case of frickin' Snowmanitan here, even at sub-optimal performance. If you like this content and you want to see more like it, make sure to subscribe to SwagTips. And if you got any questions on this content, comment below, let me know what's up. I'll be happy to help you out. Oh, almost forgot. Cursola. Cursola. The evolution of the ghost type Cursola. G-Stone, most likely. Pretty good stats. Third best ghost DPS. I honestly don't see it being that hot, especially when we get the Gen 8 in Pokemon Go. But it's not terrible, which is good. Mono ghost type. So the fact that it's lacking the secondary typing might help it stand out. We'll have to see in 2023.